Good morning, students. So today we are back with the relation and function, the part 3. So what we are going to do today, we will be discussing representation of relation, how it can be represented, and also we will do a few sums. So representation means, I mean that there are three representations, you know. One is a roster representation, as same as set theory. In the same way, the sets are represented, relations are also represented. Roster, that means directly you write out the ordered pairs within braces, that is the roster form. Second is of course the set builder form. Set builder form, here we write the ordered pair as x comma y, and hence we write the condition and also the source. And the third one is arrow diagram. Okay, so I will try to write a relation. Okay, try to write a relation in all these three forms, like three representations I will write. So let us take a set as A equals to say 1, 2, 3, 4. The four elements, and B equals to say something like 1, 4, 9, 16, then 20. So these are the two sets. Now I give the set builder representation first, that means R1 is something like x comma y, such that x square is equal to y, and you know x belongs to A and y belongs to B. So this is what, this is the set builder representation. This is the set builder representation. Now we are trying to write the arrow diagram representation for this. So how the arrow diagram representation will be? So here I get 1, 2, 3 and 4, and here I got 1, 4, 9, 16 and then 20. So as you know, this is set A, x elements, and set B, y elements. So x squared equals to y, so that condition you write over here, and squaring x you are getting y, so 1 is related to 1. 2 square equals to 4, 3 square equals to 9, and 4 square equals to 16. So for arrow diagram, always you know the arrow drawing is must, that means the connection and the arrow direction, that is must. So this refers that 4 is connected to 16, 3 is connected to 9 as per this condition. So this is the arrow diagram representation. Now the lastly, we will write the roster form representation. That means we are directly going to write the elements. So R1 will be something like 1 comma 1, then 2 comma 4, then 3 comma 9, and 4 comma 16. So this is the what, the roster form. Hope you understood this. So a particular relation can be represented in these three ways. Sometimes you will get arrow diagram representation in the exam also. They will ask you to draw the arrow diagram representation. So in that way, you will draw sets like this, and then you will connect A to B. In general, we can write that R1 is what? R1 is a relation from set A to B. And the condition is what? Condition is x square equals to y. So this is the in general thing. So A to B, it's traveling, the elements are connected, and
This is how x and y for A elements and B elements respectively. So this is how the arrow diagram representation is drawn. And already you know about roster and set builder. That means the elements here are written directly. That means for roster form and for set builder form, it's kind of a mathematical statement we write in set builder form. So now what we'll do, we will try to do the a few sums on relation. Let us do. So now what I do, I'll write a sum. I have written a sum already from NCERT exercise 2.2. This is sum number 3. You can see that two sets are given, that is set A with elements 1, 2, 3, 5 and set B elements 4, 6, 9. So they are asking define a relation from R to B, R A to B, such that the difference between X and Y is odd. Okay, that means the difference between X and Y is odd. So that means some relation from A to B you have to write. So this is how they have given the source, and the difference between X and Y is odd. So here we see that the X elements are 1, 2, 3, 5 and B elements are, Y elements are 4, 6 and 9. So that means we will try to find out the difference of the elements which are odd. Okay. So if I write the set builder form, it will be something like this. X, Y such that Y minus X is odd, where X belongs to A and Y belongs to B. So you can write out the things like 1, then 4. So all the elements we consider, we can write out. 1 and 6 also we can write out, because it's giving 5, then 2, 9 also, we can write 2, 9. Okay, then 3, 4. Then 3, 6 also we can write. Then we can write 5, 9. So you see, are there any other elements apart from this? All are written? I believe one more. That is 5, 4 to be also added with this 5 and 4. Okay, 5, 4 to be also added with this. So actually in this sum we are writing the, there is no something like that. It should be, see over here what happens. Over here it's actually producing a negative value. That means minus 7. And over here it's producing positive value. So better you can replace. So there is no such as such that the negative odd numbers will not be considered or the positive odd numbers will only be considered. So what we can do, we can write the difference like this. That means difference will be odd. Any of X and Y could be greater or smaller, doesn't matter. Okay, so this is the roster representation which we can get from the given set builder representation of the sum. Is it okay? So next sum we are going to proceed with. So we start with Psalm number 6. I have written, chosen a psalm. There they have given some relation over here and asked to find you the dominant range of R. So dominant range are theories which we have already discussed in the previous part while doing the relations. So if you do not know about dominant range, please go through. You will find everything is discussed in details. So this is the set, that means this will be the source, and some kind of x comma x plus 5 is given to given over here as the ordered pair. So the roster form of this will be, it will start from what? 0. So if you add 0 plus 5, you will get 5. So 0, 5. 5 is also present over there. We can write 0, 5. Okay. Next, if you put 1, you will get 1 plus 5, which is not there. So 1 comma 6 is not there. Okay. So over here, what we see that x belongs to, but still x is given as this. So we can use the values. Still 6 is not there. This is not some set given. So x you can put and get the following value. So if you put 1 over there, you will get a 6 over here. Okay. Now, next is 2. So you put your numbers and get the things. So then 3 comma 8, we write the things, 4 comma 9 and 5 comma 10. Here we stop. Okay. Here we stop. Now we have to find out the domain and range. Now you know domain, by domain we mean the first element, that is the x element, set of x elements or the set of pre-images we denote by the domain. So we write, so domain of R, this is also a set which is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay, and range will be given as the set of y elements. So when you write range of R, this will give you 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this sum, that means this above sum which we have just done, I will try to modify it a little. Okay, and then we want to do the sum. The same sum we are doing. Just find out R equals to, it's given that x comma x plus 5, okay, and x belongs to 8 and y. So this is y, y equals to x plus 5, and xy belongs to 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So I have just modified this a little. Okay, that means here x and y both should belong to that particular set. Look at this part. This part is very important. And with the introduction of y, the sum is a little different. That means this element is written as y, xy. So here xy both belongs to this. So here if you want to write, here if you want to write out the ordered pairs, it will be only 0 comma 5, nothing else. Here it is closed. Just to check it out very carefully, because if you put 1, then it becomes what? 1 comma 6, and 6 is not there. That means when the value of y is 6, so y does not belong to the 6, value is not there, so y cannot take the 6 value. So this will be the answer in case of this. Just an introduction of y. But here what happened? Here y is anything, it depends on x. So x controls basically the value of y, but here although x determines some value, but since that value is not belonging to this particular set, so y cannot take up that value for answer. Okay, so here if you do the domain of, I'll name it R1, that would be better. R1 is only 0. It's only 0, and range of R1 is only 5. Hope you understood this. So range will be only 5. So thank you. Next part we will do some other things, especially we'll start with the function part.